Welcome to Politics Done Right on KPFT. I am your host, Egberto Williams. This is the progressive program that will take the mystery out of politics. This is the program that will encourage you to make sure government becomes we the people. Whether you are liberal, conservative, or otherwise, you get to air your point of view. Give me a call at 713-526-5738. That is 713-526-KPFT. Remember, you can also send me a tweet to EGBERTOWILLIES. That is at Egberto Williams. Let us engage. It is politics done right.
1, 2, 3, 4. Edition of Politics Done Right. I'm Egberto Willis, your host. Thank you so kindly for spending this time with us. We are going to have a great show today, but not only are we going to have a great show today, but you are going to be a part of it exactly in a manner that we need you to be a part of it now. And what are we talking about? We're talking about progressive radio needing you. We are talking about you being a part of our success. We're talking about you being you. You remember Obama used to say that thing where he said, you have been waiting on whom? You have been waiting on you. So anyhow, folks, let's get busy with the show. But beforehand, let me say, how are you doing, my dear Shannon?
I'm doing well, and you are so right. We have a special guest in the studio so that it brings the progressive voice here in Houston straight to you from the grassroots.
Absolutely. Hello. So we have the honor of having Kay West with us, and Kay West is the president of the Houston area Progressives. Kay, how are you doing today?
I'm doing well, and I'm hoping to hear that the progressives are going to call in and make it rain.
Absolutely. And what do we want it to rain when the progressives call in?
We want it to rain some donations, some cash. Support. Let's keep this afloat. This is what we are about.
Absolutely. Absolutely so, folks. But look, what I'm going to do, because we're going to be here, stay with the show. I know a lot of times when you hear that, oh my God, KPFT is in one of those fun drive modes that you don't, that you kind of run away. Don't run away, because we have an enlightening show for you today. Mm-hmm. We're going to be discussing issues today as we ask you at the same time to give us a call. And it only takes about, a couple of minutes, Shannon, to go ahead and make a pledge?
That's right. They say about 90 seconds.
Yes, and we must raise north of $600. And you know what? Before I get to talk a little bit about the show, do we have Teresa out there in Central?
We do. She's standing by.
Well, Teresa, you have a big offer that you want to make our people. And folks, remember that I say stay with us. We have some important topics to discuss. Teresa, tell me a little bit about that offer.
Well, thank you very much for having me in the Pledge Central with you today. Yes, a generous donor has offered a challenge, but
there's something we must complete.
Yes, you must meet your goal. I want you to collect at least $600 in pledges, and this person will kick in another $200.
So you hear that, folks? We need to raise $600 now, and when we raise $600, a very generous person is going to be there to provide us with $200. But Teresa, we're going to be back with you, Teresa, but what I want to do is get the show rolling so that people can hear what we want to talk about today, and then we'll move on. Is that okay with you, my dear?
That's great.
That's a challenge for you, dear listener. So please remember to call 713-526-5738 to make that donation of support today to KPFT. Your progressive voice here in Houston.
Absolutely. We want you. We need you. But anyhow, folks, it is time for progressives to become the real Democratic Party establishment. It is no longer the time for progressives to seek understanding from the Democratic Party. It is time for progressives to become the Democratic Party. Today's guest is Kay West, the president of the Houston area Progressives. Please note that for progressives to get their message across, it is imperative that sources that promote our our values are funded appropriately. KPFT 90.1 FM is the progressive station in the entire Southeast Texas of value, something that is a gem in this community that needs your support. That is, we talk the talk, we walk the walk. You sit, you watch the people around here. Everybody's here working on a volunteer basis to ensure that you, my friend, get the type of info, the type of news, the type of the things that you don't get anywhere else. Anyhow, folks, but we need your support. Please call 713-526-5738. Again, that number is 713-526-5738 now, and make a contribution and or become a member in the area in this great era of whom? Donald Trump. Look, the only way we're going to be able to get our view out there is for us to be here. So go ahead, visit our website, politicsdoneright.com, get to the page and provide your support. Anyhow, folks, before I get to the program, I want to remind all our listeners that KPFT is a bastion of intelligent voices and programs. As a political activist myself, my favorites are The Monitor with
Mark Babawi. He has a great program. Mondays at 7 p.m.
We've got Think Wing Radio with Mike Honig at
on Mondays at 9 p.m.
And we have Partisan Gridlock with Jeff Berg on
that's on Fridays at 3 p.m.
And Open Journal with
well, with Dwayne Bradley, Marlo Blue, and none other than Hedy Van Bagel every single weekday at 8 a.m.
And Jazz Latino, Afro-Cuban Latin Jazz at its best, hosted by
none other than Juan Flores.
Juan Flores on
that's on Mondays at 10 p.m.
10 p.m., you got it right. And then, of course, we have The Human Condition at 3 p.m., followed by The Free Minstrel Show with Don and Dwayne at 4 p.m. on Fridays on KPFT, the HD3 side. Anyhow, folks, check out our full schedule at kpft.org, where you can find programming from music to politics to medicine to the eclectic. KPFT is a listener-supported public community radio station, so please remember that if you like what you hear, visit kpft.org and ensure we remain a strong, viable community radio station that provides news, programming, and information not influenced by the
corporatocracy.
We want to make sure, right? What is that, Kay? Not influenced by whom?
Corporatocracy.
You've got that right. Anyhow,
my first big word.
Your first big word. You were talking about big
first
words
of
earlier,
many.
Right? I tell you. Anyhow, this is KPFT 90.1 FM Houston, Texas. We want to hear your voice. We want to hear your thoughts. So let's talk. I'll also be following hashtag politics done right. So folks, please call now. We're about to get into the blog of the week, but we want to hear you now. 713-526-5738. She has a much sweeter, nicer voice than I have. So why don't you tell them the number to call in?
It's 713-526-5738. You're trying to butter me up, huh?
I'm not buttering you. You're self-buttering. What can I say?
Well, we have some great volunteers out there to take your pledges. We have Stu standing by phone one and Miranda, a newer volunteer. I've been training on the boards. She's ready to take your phone.
So, folks, remember, I have to raise $600 or they're going to throw me out of the stage. Actually, they won't, but I mean, we need your support. And actually, I'd like to raise, the truth of the matter, I would love to make KPFT proud and raise $10,000 right now and get this stuff going. Don't you think, Kay?
Absolutely.
We be really going for that?
Absolutely. And after what Trump has said when he talked about CNN, like they were like some small entity, I think it's very necessary that we get out and we support these voices because you're going to need that information.
Absolutely. So Kay is absolutely right. So folks, I'm asking you, and we're going to get into the blog of the week and we're going to get into some real good talk in here with Kay. But to get that going, I need you to call 713-526-5738. Again, that number is 713-526-5738. Please call now. But folks, do you know what time it is?
It's time for the weekly blog post.
And as soon as my pad behaves itself, which it just did, luckily as the last bell rang, we're going to start. Mainstream media projecting as they accuse BuzzFeed of fake news on Trump's dossier. That is the topic today before we move on to the other great topics. Anyway, here it goes. It would not be long before the mainstream media ran for cover. BuzzFeed gave them a gem, and they were happy to base much of their reporting on it. But in these times of fake news, euphoria turned into panic. The Trump dossier filled with salacious allegations with tapes supposedly held by the Russians is unverified. And you know what? BuzzFeed reported it as such. Here's what BuzzFeed said. Quote, a dossier making explosive but unverified allegations that the Russian government has been cultivating, supporting, and assisting President-elect Donald Trump for years and gained compromising information about him has been circulating about among elected officials, intelligence agents, and journalists for weeks. The dossier, which is a collection of memos written over a period of months, includes specific unverified and potentially unverifiable allegations of contact between Trump aides and Russian operatives and graphic claims of sexual acts documented by the Russians. BuzzFeed News report. In the U.S. and Europe have been investigating various alleged facts in the dossier but have not verified or falsified them, CNN reported Tuesday that a two-page synopsis of the report was given to President Obama and Trump. So both of them saw that. Now BuzzFeed News is publishing the full document so that Americans can make up their own minds. So anyhow, anybody who read the BuzzFeed report realized that they said this was unverified. This was, in other words, they reported it saying, hey guys, here it is. This is what's been around for over a year. Tell me what you think. Of course, every major news outlet ran with the story, even with the various disclaimers. After Donald Trump vehemently denied the allegations and called out BuzzFeed and CNN for delivering fake news, what do you think the mainstream did? They panicked. The mainstream media panicked. The panic started. The panic set in. The Atlantic's David Graham wrote, Smith's reasoning is sincere. Smith is sincere and considered, but the conclusion is highly dubious. Even more perturbing was the reasoning in the published story. Ben Smith is whom? The publisher of BuzzFeed. Chuck Todd, or rather the New York Times' Kelly McBride wrote, By publishing an unverified report alleging the Russians have compromising information on President-elect Donald Trump, BuzzFeed made it less likely that truth will be journalists' only goal and less likely that when the truth surfaces, the public will believe it. Chuck Todd, you know, the venerable Chuck Todd, interviewed Ben Smith and outright accused him of publishing fake news. Later in the same interview, Todd had a striking statement. He quoted Washington Post Margaret Sullivan, who said, it's never been acceptable to publish rumor and innuendo. Really? Really? Hypocrites populate the mainstream, folks. BuzzFeed's releasing unsubstantiated dossier on Trump is no different than Trump's unsubstantiated birther utterances that the press ran with throughout President Obama's presidency. The Trump dossier is still rumor and innuendo, while birtherism was always a verifiable lie given traction by the mainstream media. Those people that are really attacking BuzzFeed now, weren't they the one trafficking in this type of news before? Of course they were. Anyhow, the concern for press believability that New York Times' Kelly McBride expressed is way too late. Much of the mainstream media just allows the airwaves and space to be taken over by those expounding lies to ensure that an ill-informed and confused electorate will continue to empower the few, the plutocracy that continues to pilfer them. Allowing proponents of trickle-down economics to get on the airwaves and promote it as policy that creates jobs and encourages wealth building for the masses when reality and deterministic numerical analysis proves otherwise is fake news. The mainstream media lies with their acquiescence on our virtual silence. When somebody goes on to ABC, CBS, and they lie and the reporter says nothing, that's fake news. That's what they're supporting. Anyhow, continuing. Obamacare, even with all its flaws, can be shown to be mathematically superior to the laissez-faire, evil, and inhumane healthcare orthodoxy practiced by this country. And yet, the mainstream media prostitute the airwaves to give a platform to those who lie for the ideological reasons. In today's climate, where few justifiably have little faith in the mainstream media, it was justified for BuzzFeed's calculations to release the dossier. In fact, they should have released it before the election. Trump's irrational love for Vladimir Putin and his inability to accept that Russia was destabilizing our election justifies the publication of the dossier. Exploring why he would endanger Americans by adopting Putin's desired policies for NATO means examining all of the pertinent data in the public domain. Trump's deafness to the Russian attack on our election, even with all our intelligence agencies coalescing on that reality, leads one to believe Russia just might have something on him. The ubiquitously circulated dossier thus deserves examination. The mainstream media's condemnation of BuzzFeed on this issue is unjustified. First, they do not have the credibility to do so, given their inability to prevent their airwaves and other properties from being used for disseminating life-altering lies. Second, they continue to function as wards of the plutocracy by only promoting their ideology over what is best for Americans and humanity as a whole. It is now time that the alternative media stand up. Until mainstream media live up to its constitutional role, they will remain irrelevant. They will remain irrelevant. And the only relevant form of news that we can really have is independent media. And who is independent media? A media like whom?
We are.
KPFT.
Just like us. KPFT, independent through and through.
Absolutely. Someone that can bring somebody like President Kay West here of the Houston area progressives
to
talk to us about this. But before we go to UK, I want to ask, folks, I'm asking you generously, kindly, please give us a call at 713-526-5738.
Or pledge online at kpft.org. That's simple, easy, painless. And then you get to actually support the radio station that matters to you, that brings you talk shows like Politics Done Right. Every Thursday, without fail.
Absolutely. Let's go back to Pledge Central.
Teresa, do you have anything to add?
Please tell me you have something to add, Teresa.
I hate to say this. What we do have is someone that is willing to chip in $200 if we will raise $600, and you have 45 more minutes to do it. So
okay.
help Egberto out here, everybody. It costs about $150 an hour to run a station. We have 100,000 watts, goes almost all the way to Brenham, down to Huntsville. You know, it's broad. It costs a lot for the power to generate that, and we have dedicated people like Egberto that bring in guests and do great news and analysis. Please support this station. Call in right now. Be one of those people that help us meet that goal of $600 and create a little bonus for KPFT.
Absolutely. And folks, please remember, don't wait till the last minute to call in. I beg thee of not to do that because, you know, the show is going to, you know, we're going to continue with the show, but we need you to give us a call at 713-526-573 and tell us a little bit about our two gifts that we have or more that we're going to go ahead and provide here for those who want a gift after donating. But think about it. Think about giving Politics Done Right a coffee a week or a coffee a month or something like that. Is that too much to ask in order to get some good progressive news out there for you?
I hope it is not too much to ask, but we definitely need to hear from you. You know that, you know, commercial-free radio is more important than ever because we need an independent voice that is willing to bring you the stories you deserve to know. As we embark in the new brave world of Donald Trump. We definitely need an independent source of media out there. So, you know, just like that, we need to hear from you, dear listener.
It sounds like.
And if you pledge $90, you can get a Politics Done Right t-shirt.
It sounds like you caught a venereal disease. And you say,
that's right. That's right. We do need to hear from you. So please call 713-526-5738 right now. Please, please, please.
Absolutely, folks. So again, that number is 713-526-5738. Now with us, we have Kay West, president of the Houston Area Progressives. Kay, why don't you first tell me a little bit, before we even go about your group, tell us a little bit about you and what got you involved. Because what I try to preach on this show is that our body politic depend on you. It's not somebody else. You decided to take the ball and run. And run,
absolutely,
you did. Tell us a little bit about yourself first.
I'm from Lake Charles, Louisiana. Came to Houston. And when I came to Houston, when I came to Houston, it was all Republican. There was no thought process of a Democrat. And I actually licked stamps for Bush,
if you
can believe it.
I
yeah. And at the time, that was my first advance into politics, and I didn't really think much past that. Mm-hmm. And this is when he was running for governor. I'm telling my age. And so then I went to L.A., mm-hmm. where all enlightened people go.
Right.
And while I was in L.A., that's when my thought process really started to come in. And when I came back to Texas, I became a burner, mm-hmm. and I became a delegate. Mm-hmm. And all bushy-eyed and bushy-tail, I went to the national delegate. And when I found myself contained, as a light word, but contained by officers with guns in the media room, not getting any attention for right. being contained, and it just blew my mind that they were actually telling us that we couldn't leave.
Right.
And I couldn't believe it, because it's like, well, hold up, I'm a delegate. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm not somebody running out onto the street that's not supposed to
right.
be here. And they kept us in there for about 2 hours.
Right.
And so, go ahead.
No, so now, so you got into politics you got into progressive politics after you returned from LA. LA and came out here. Now, how did you get together to form the Houston Area Progressives, something that is definitely needed out here in this county, in this city, in this county? We need a whole lot of these in the state.
Absolutely. We need different ideas. We need, might I say, the right ideas.
Right.
When I got back from the DNC, mm-hmm. and was disillusioned, mm-hmm. and very disappointed.
Right.
And felt very disrespected.
Right.
And so,
As a burner. Yes.
Yeah. As a human being. Citizen.
Right.
You know, we can come to the table with different ideas, but there is no reason for you to treat me in disrespect when you claim that's how you were treated
right.
with Obama and Hillary.
Right.
So, and now you're treating me the same way.
Right.
And when all I'm doing is asking for $15 for
right.
a minimum wage, when all I'm doing is asking you to stop the criminalization of immigrants,
right.
when all I'm asking you to do is, hey, maybe we should be checking about what's going on in our prison systems. Maybe you shouldn't be charging family members $20 for 30 minutes of Skype
right.
when Skype is free.
Right, right. I mean, in other words, you are supporting what most Americans, whether liberal or otherwise, support. And you found the party itself was not
receptive
to what you wanted, or not to what we all want.
Yeah, not receptive at all. It was sort of like treating someone like they were a little child, and it's like, well, you know, a child does grow up.
Right.
You know, I don't need a spanking from you. I need guidance, and it would have been nice to have that elderly guidance into the process. But not this elderly guidance, and this is what you should be thinking.
Now, we always talk about the establishment, both of the Democratic Party and the establishment of the Republican Party. Do you feel that a lot of the reporting was probably responsible for these people believing it was okay to treat some of these delegates the way that they were treated within our own democracy?
I think that came down. I think that's... It's sort of like when you work at a bad company.
Mm-hmm.
I think that just came down from the owners.
Mm-hmm.
And at this particular point, those owners were Hillary Clinton and Deborah Wasserman.
Wasserman Schultz, yeah.
And, you know, to jail people for the very essence of freedom of speech, to me, is mind-boggling. To sit there and watch our president say we hold these truths self-evident, and at the same exact time they are telling people that you cannot speak, you cannot hold a sign. What world was I in?
I
felt like I was in the Twilight Zone. And for me, as an African American, and being so proud of what this president meant to the eyes of my two boys, I walked out.
Right.
Because it was too much,
right.
and I couldn't believe it. And I saw, you know, older African Americans who were staunch Hillary. I was like, wow, is this what the dogs sicked on us was for?
Well,
for you to then do the same thing to me that those white people did to you in the 60s?
Right. No, let me come back at that, because I think that is a very, very important concept, right? And I think that is one of the reasons why I just met you a couple of days. Although I should have seen you at the DNC. I don't remember seeing you at the DNC.
Oh, you should have. I was looking real cute. You should have really seen me. I was looking. I was. I had my Kate Spade down, hair, heels. I was there.
Were you in the Texas delegation?
Yes.
Okay, I didn't see you in the Texas delegation. Our delegation, it was pretty large, you know, how, and we were all over the place. But anyhow, it's what I think is important, and I think this is what a lot of us meet. And in fact, I was talking to Hank outside about it. There are a lot of progressives, and there are a lot of progressives with different degrees of thought and how things are supposed to be doing. But most importantly, there are many progressives just think that they have to just hold on to what they have, and to just give a little bit of help to the thought process of those people that you saw sitting down, and you're saying, is that what you went through in the 60s, and now just sit down and watch somebody do that to you? My thing to them is fear. And the reason that fear comes across, in my opinion, is that we need more of what you're doing now. When you have the Houston area progressive,
Yes.
out there, you're able to tell people they don't only have to adapt to what's given to them, but they can
Absolutely.
Demand what they must have. And that is one of the things we try to preach.
I say, let's try on some of this white entitlement. Let's try it on. Everybody.
Hey, Shannon, she's going to use some of your white entitlement, man.
Take it.
I would hope. That's what I love so much about one thing that I learned, because I'm not a millennial. I'm
right.
older.
Uh-huh.
And one thing that I learned from this process, because I not only did I go to the DNC,
right.
I marched from Washington, D.C. to the DNC
right.
with a lot of millennials.
Okay.
And one thing that I learned is, and we joked about it, is like that awareness now
right.
of that entitlement
right.
as opposed to not before. And what I thought was lovely is a few of them wanted to go ahead and steal that white entitlement and give it to us.
Right. Well, you know, the millennials, and that is what conservatives fear the most. And
oh, they should.
And that is because millennials or people, well, I mean,
they're smart,
and not only that, they grew up integrated, and not only did they grow up integrated, but they know in that process, because they grew up integrated, because all their friends look like a lot of other folk as well, and they all realize, oh darn, we all want the same thing. They don't share the fear that these other people have.
I think it's funny. It really does boil down to living in larger cities,
right,
and in education,
right.
I've traveled a lot around this world and around this country specifically, and you know, for my brothers and sisters of another color, from another mother, that's in Kentucky,
mm-hmm.
that's in Louisiana, you know, I've always said that we need to, in this country, we need to, and as progressives,
mm-hmm.
if we will succeed, we're going to have to learn that right now we are living with someone that we hate.
Right.
And we're going to have to figure it out, because we can't divorce.
And
you can divorce your wife,
but
you can't divorce another patriot.
That is perfect. And you know what? Let me take a little break here so that we can go into some pitching, which is very important right now. So, folks, let me go ahead and ask you again to give us a call at 713-526. We're going to be off a little bit from talking so that you can get away from the radio and go to the phone. And please give us a call at 713-526-5738. Again, that number is 713-526-5738. Sean, why don't you tell them about the book and the t-shirt?
You better believe it. I can do that, Egberto. Okay, so your book, can you class warfare? How do you?
It is, as I see it, class warfare, the only resort to right-wing doom.
We are offering that book at the $90 pledge level. Also, we have a shirt, a Politics Done Right t-shirt, also at the $90 level. So if you want a combo pack of the two of those, that's $150. If
right.
I could speak today, good. But yes, if you want to make those in payments, a payment plan, and we can mail that to you once that payment is complete, we'd be happy to boil that down for you. That would be about 41 cents per day, $12.50 per month. We would love to send that to you.
That's 3 Starbucks coffees a month. Can you do that for KPFT? Think about it.
You know, and like you were saying, about millennials. My mother, okay, and as a contrast to what I grew up with, mm-hmm. my mother went to Lamar High School in the 60s. It was completely white.
Right.
That was a totally different Houston.
Wow, their football team must have sucked.
Hey, you're stereotyping, my friend.
But it's amazing how far, you know, how far we've come, but also, right. it's amazing how far we still need to go.
Right.
And having this progressive voice, having this independent, unique radio station that can bring you programs like this, where we can have these conversations that you just won't find anywhere else, and we can bring you on. You call in each week, and we're so glad you can participate, and you bring up such interesting points that are important to make. So, you know, whatever it takes, you know you value this resource.
Absolutely.
That's why you're listening in right now.
Tell those millennials out there and all the other millennial-minded people that to throw on some gangsta rap and call here and make it rain.
You know what I like to hear? You know what I also like what you just said? I'm going to start using that. The millennials are the
millennial thinking, I think is what I said.
Yeah, the
millennial minded.
The millennial minded. I'm a millennial minded person because I'm an older person, but I try to hang with the Shannons and so forth to make me a little bit younger.
You're funny, but you know, it's interesting. It's dynamic. It's living, real radio.
Absolutely. So, folks, give us a call at 713-526-5738. Again, 713-526-5738. I haven't heard those phones ring at all.
What's going on out there,
What's
Teresa?
Going on out there?
Well, I just wanted you to know I'm sending a text to the liberal ladies.
Good.
See if they want to contribute. We did have one person that heard what you had to say, and she said, I'm going to give an additional, in addition to what she's already giving, she's going to give an additional $60 this year.
Wonderful.
To Politics Done Right.
Thank you so much.
She was inspired. Oh, these are more? Yep. You got more?
Yay! Let's hear it.
Let's hear who we need to thank now.
That was Karen, and then we have, so you pronounce this Jaime, starts with, it looks like H-A-I-M-E.
Jaime,
and he has pledged $100. Thank you, Jaime.
Thank you very much, Jaime.
Karen and Jaime, and thank you.
We don't have his email. I encourage you when you call in to give us your email if you'd like to be on the notification list to be notified of some of our events. And we have another person. Oh, my goodness. He split it up. I don't know why he did that. But yes, it actually comes up to 150 total.
Yay!
Absolutely.
So thank you for getting us kicked off on this fun drive. This is day one.
Absolutely. We need those phones ringing like crazy, folks. Remember, if we can get to $600, we have an additional $200 that somebody has pledged, which helps KPFT along the line. Look,
we can't let that go to waste.
Can't let it go. And right now, our fun drive has been a bit slower than usual. I mean, I know people just got off of the political season and times are hard, but we need you to know this. In this era of Trump, in this era where you watch Trump shut, you actually watch Trump
shut
down the media. Mm-hmm. He cannot shut us down because we are not scared of Trump. I mean, CNN has to be careful because he can go ahead and do certain things with other small businesses and tell them, don't buy ads at CNN. Don't buy ads at these places.
Or frustrating.
And you know
pull
what?
The strings on the news,
right,
you know? The information system that we have here,
right.
That is what's really disgusting.
And
that's what we're proud that we don't have to depend on.
They can't do that to us because, again, he could go to Ford Motors and say, if you don't stop advertising with CNN, we are going to move those defense contracts elsewhere.
And believe me, those bosses definitely care
absolutely.
About that.
But you, those people that are hearing my voice at this point in time, you control your own media in KPFT. You are the one in control, and we need you to be in control.
Yeah,
why?
We're people-powered radio because it's so crucial to stay informed. It
Absolutely.
Is so crucial to have your point of view known out there, that you're not just labeled and grouped together mm-hmm. and, well, kept closed off.
Absolutely.
You know?
And what we're trying to do now, folks, is make sure that everybody has a voice.
That's right.
Every single Houstonian, every single Southeast Texas person, every single person listening to us
yes.
on kpft.org, every person within ear distance from our voices.
And we know we reach quite far out there. We reach the Galveston.
We even reach England. We've actually got donations from England.
If you're listening online, they understand the value of free speech.
Absolutely. So, I mean, the thing about it, though, folks, is we do a lot of complaining, right, Kay? I mean, Kay, if you take a look at sometimes, you'll be out there and you'll notice somebody say, oh, why isn't this happening? Or why aren't they reporting the right news? And we have to, a lot of times, I don't get frustrated. I don't get upset. I have learned how to control all of that. But sometimes to some, you can see that it's upsetting because of this. How comes we're not getting the right news? You are. You're just, many people are just choosing to stay with the big boys. Go ahead.
Well, life in general, life is going to take effort.
Right.
And if you want the correct news, and this whole idea now of, well, not even idea, the existence now of what used to be just entertainment news, which has now become
news,
exactly. And now we have this fake news, and we're listening to a guy who's the godfather of fake news. Mm-hmm. I mean, he literally godfathered his way in. Yes. He started it all. And this is where you come, but you have to support. It just is what it is.
It's like the original snake
oil. You have to pay the cost
salesman
to be the boss.
What's that, Teresa?
He's like the original snake oil.
Oh, absolutely.
Salesman.
Yes.
The original man behind the curtain.
But, you know, it's important. But what we have to realize is the good thing about the KPFT and why, folks, we need KPFT to survive. And, you know, every time we come listen, Shannon, every time we come here, right, we tell folks, oh, things are like in dire straits, right? Well, you know, at a community radio, things are always in dire straits. Always. And you know why? Because we are working from the masses. We are working from the people, the regular, everyday American. We're not going to get...
Not the corporatocracy.
I love that. But anyhow, but yes, folks, so as it turns out, we need you. But we need you to invest a few bucks. I mean, you know,
may I say something?
Yes.
I'd like people to make a trade-off. Coming up on the 21st, the day after the inauguration, a lot of people are going to be going to Austin. Some people are going to Washington, D.C. Maybe you're one of those people that's paid over $300 to catch a bus to D.C.
Right.
And I commend you because, I mean, people need to see, you know, that mass of humanity that says, hey, you know, you need to pay attention to progressive issues. You need to pay attention to women. You know, you need to be more compassionate, whatever. There are other people that are going to Austin. I know that there are many buses going to Austin where people are getting together and they're talking.
Mm-hmm.
Kumbaya, you know, they're singing together. They're talking together all the way to Austin, make a statement and come back. So maybe you're one of those people that can't do that. But would you please, for the benefit of everyone else, take $60 and pledge it to KPFT. That would be enough to send two people to Austin, for example.
Absolutely.
If you're not going, think about, well, you know, I'm not going. This is the way I kind of rationalize it in my mind. I'm not going to. I mean, you have to choose what steps you take, what statements you make, and how you make those statements. You know, pledge to community radio. And I want to mention two other people who called in. We've got Kurt and... he has pledged $100. Thank you.
Thank you,
Kurt.
So kindly, Kurt.
Thank you.
We
thank
appreciate
you.
That very much.
And we have Sharon. And Kurt is getting the Politics Done Right t-shirt.
Yay.
And
fun.
Yeah, and we have Sharon. Sharon is pledging $100. So
thank you, Sharon.
Thank you, Sharon.
So we're up to $410.
Folks,
so we're very close to the goal. We have 20 minutes, but don't make us wait. So
no.
I hope those people are out there. You're thinking, you know, there's other people that are paying to get on that bus to make that statement with friends. How can I help make a statement? One great way to do it is to support community radio so people can hear these stories. And, you know, and people, when you call in, you know, tell us a little story. I love to hear.
And we'll tell your stories. Story, yeah. And
maybe our guest has a good story or two that is still.
Our guest has a lot of good stories.
Thank you for that call. So let's do the rundown. We have Sharon to thank. We have Kurt. We have Jaime and Karen. And who else? I just want to make sure I'm having jotted
Sharon,
down.
Sharon, Kurt, Jaime, and I don't know why Jaime put did it twice.
But I tell you what, I want to ask you guys to go ahead and call now. We're going to get back to Kay. Well, I'm saying we're going to get back to Kay. We don't need to get back to Kay. Kay is an integral part of this discussion. But
I want to say thank you to those First Amendment warriors too.
Yes.
Absolutely so. Absolutely so, Kay. But folks, look, we need you to keep calling 713-526-5738. Again, that number is 713-526-5738.
And thank you so much for your support.
Calls. Absolutely. It is so important. And I, you know, my goal today, our goal is all of our goals.
Yes.
$600. But you know what? We want to be more helpful to KPFT because KPFT has had a hard time in all these fund drives, and we need your support because you know what? There are a lot of things that we have in store going forward. I can tell you that. I can tell you, stay tuned. There are a lot of things for Progressive Radio. This Progressive Radio, KPFT 90.1 FM, has in store to bring you your progressive news. Well, I shouldn't say progressive news. I should say to bring you news.
Yes, the news you deserve.
Real news is progressive, right?
The right news.
Because the right news is progressive. Truth is progressive. And that is what we are going to bring to you. So again, please call 713-526-5738.
Help assure community control of the radio.
I love that. I love that, Shannon. This is, and folks, let me remind you, this is your radio station.
Radio
at any time, you can come in here. And when we're calling it radio station because we're on air, 100,000 watts, 90.1 FM. But we are also on Facebook Live. A lot of you, I am pretty sure by the time I get home, those numbers are going to be way, way up. So we give it to you on the radio as well. We give it to you streaming as well. And of course, it's all archived, both at kpft.org and at politicsdoneright.com. But let me get back with Kay. So Kay,
yes, sir.
Tell me a little bit about what are you going to do what part are you going to play now? In fact, when I asked you to be on the show, it's because I am so embarrassed to say that I wasn't aware of Houston area progressives, but I always put my faults out there.
You cannot believe this.
You cannot believe it. I understand that. But the first thing I did when I said it is, I've got to have you on the show.
Yes, you did. Houston area progressives is a new group. We started in July.
Mm-hmm.
And since we've been back, Houston area progressives' primary objectives is to get candidates, get local officials and have them be progressive.
Mm-hmm.
That's the primary focus. And it's obviously it's progressive candidates, and it's progressive candidates with the same type of ideas. We do not value really putting in people that are middle of the ground.
Mm-hmm.
We're not hard on it, but we want you for the things that we want, like the 15, the making sure that Houston does not commit to helping the Trump administration with the criminalization mm-hmm. of immigration. Just things of this nature. We all know, most of us know the progressive values that we share. And so we're about making it local.
Mm-hmm.
So we want the precinct chairs. We're trying to fill in the precinct chairs mm-hmm. with progressive minds. And we also, we pushed and walked and make calls for Kim Ogg.
Mm-hmm.
So we're really happy that she's now elected.
I think you did your job.
Thank you. I think we did too, because we really pushed it in. I mean, I know that money from that guy helped a lot, but it was also
the footwork. The grassroots.
Yes.
Yeah.
And absolutely with Ann Sung,
mm-hmm.
we were out there. So this is when you realize in a city of Houston how strong those positions and how valuable those positions who we look over all the time, all those precinct chairs, that we need to make sure that we have progressives in there. We actually saw Harris County go blue, and now we want to keep it blue.
And we want to bring in all the other counties, the surrounding counties. I know that Houston is more than one county. So, I mean, I imagine
for
that
the
you
Harris,
cover
the Fort Bend. I live in Harris
Montgomery
County.
Montgomery as well, I think,
yes.
is a piece of Houston. If I recall, if I'm wrong, folks, you can always call me and tell me to
to get my act together.
And we're forever always trying to make sure that we align ourselves with different groups that are one issue groups.
Right.
So we can also bring that knowledge to our members and just to make sure that everyone knows like what's going on.
Okay, you know? Now I want folks to become members of HAL. I mean of
HAL. Houston Area Progressives.
And I will be a member by the end of the day. Now my question to you is, what are membership requirements? When do you meet? And how do they find you online?
You can find us online on Facebook at Houston Area Progressives. Mm-hmm. That is the easiest way. We do have a website, HoustonAreaProgressives.org, but I think the easiest and quickest way for most people is through Facebook.
Okay.
And you can become a member when you go to one of our general meetings.
Mm-hmm.
And at our general meetings are held on the third Wednesday of the month.
The third Wednesday of every month, okay?
Yes. And we're having one this Wednesday, but January 18th.
Uh-huh.
And it will be at the Midtown Bar and Grill.
Okay.
And at 7 p.m.
And
that's a general meeting. And at that particular meeting is when we describe all the events that are coming up, say, like the People's Coalition Against Trump rally that's on the 20th. We discuss those things. And we also like to have educational there. Like, we're going to have a guy, Jerry Locke, that describes, he's with the Texas Drought Project.
Mm-hmm.
So he's going to be letting us know. Because at the end of the day, it is people like myself that, you know, I understand that we're busy. Everyone's busy.
Right.
It's hard.
And but you got to do it.
Yes, you have to, because it's necessary, because at the end of the day, this one beautiful country from sea to shining sea, all my stuff is here.
Exactly.
And I don't want to move all my stuff.
No, we're staying right here. Now, what is there a cost to become a member of the Houston Area Progressives?
No, it's actually pure donation.
So you just give what you can.
Yes, you give what you can.
Okay.
And we have T-shirts and things like that on the nature of how much you give and things
right.
of that nature.
So there are really no excuse for any progressive to have a home here in this town.
If you believe that people should have a working wage, if you believe, and you know, let me say, even if you don't believe, show up so we can sit down and talk, because at the end of the day, you family.
Right. I love that you said that, because a lot of what the many of the leadership in the right has done is that they've made it believe like as if progressives and liberals are those crazy evil people, and when they sit down and talk, and that's why I don't spend my time talking to the choir. We can sit down and talk, but you know, we are of like minds.
Yes.
But I try to engage other people, and many times that engagement brings awareness, and they don't necessarily become all super progressive like you are, but they become understanding, and not only that, they can immediately
absolutely.
Become allies.
That's absolutely one of the things as Houston Area Progressives builds, one of the very things that we want to do is community involvement.
Right.
And one of the things, even the simplest thing that we plan on doing is even having just an Easter egg hunt.
Right.
So people can come and they can enjoy themselves and we can begin to talk, because at the end of the day, unless you happen to have $30 million in your back pocket, No, I don't.
Okay.
I wish I did, but I don't. But I would still be progressive.
Absolutely.
You know, what's the old saying? You know, if you wanna aim to a Republican life.
If you want
life,
to live like a Republican, vote Democrat.
Like exactly.
I mean, it is funny. I always heard that. So, Shannon.
Yes, Egberto.
Well, I always like to hear the younger voice in the conversation as well.
Well, hello.
I like to put her at the spot. I give her a hard time. But anyhow, folks, please give us a call. 713-526-5738. Again, that number is 713-526-5738. Folks, we only have 11 minutes left. I need you to call. Remember, there's somebody that's offering $200 if you donate and get me up to $600
yes,
or a bit over $600.
Yes, help us put that to work.
We need that money.
Yes, we need
Do
that
we have
money.
Any more calls? Any more to tell me about, Teresa?
Yes, I want you to know we just had a second first-time donor.
Great.
Wonderful.
Yes, and some of these people are requesting green receipts. So that means we don't have to send anything through the mail. Now, if you want
awesome.
A bumper sticker, you're going to have to send something through snail mail. But people are thinking, they're coming up with with solutions here.
Great.
And it's fitting their lifestyle. And this person wanted to contribute. His name is Wayne, and he wants to give $50.
Thank you very much, Wayne.
Thank you, Wayne.
Thank you, Wayne.
Absolutely.
And, you know, motivated a first-time listener.
Thank you very much, Wayne. Any other ones, or is that where we're at so far now?
That's the only addition since the last time.
No problem. Well, folks, I am about a couple hundred dollars short. And I need you to give us a call.
We know we have a lot of listeners out there.
Yes.
You are throughout our community. It's amazing how many people I'll talk to, and they know you. You like your inner workings. You're out there, mover, shaker. You're across the political spectrum. Doesn't matter if they're Republican, Tea Party, as you say.
I love my Tea Partiers. I love my Republicans.
Progressive, whatever walk of politics you like, that you have your finger on that pulse. And that's what's really interesting, that people like Egberto come in here that, you know, he's a full-time blogger, but he gives up time to make sure that you are in the conversation, your voice matters and it's on the air, and you trust KPFT to keep you informed and provide you with this community resource. And if you value that, we need to hear from you. So call 713-526-5738, because we count on you to support radio programming that you value.
Absolutely, folks. The time is it's coming. Yeah, go ahead, IK.
No, I just wanted to reiterate exactly what you just said. At this point, you know, you may be of the Republican Party, of the Tea Party, of if you're just independent, of the Democratic Party, but the team is Team America.
Mm-hmm. Right on.
What makes us different and makes us not British is the fact that we dissented.
Right.
So
we're in this
the
together.
Very thought of what we're doing right now, if you respect America, if you respect the value, the First Amendment, this is where you put your money where your mouth is, people. I'm challenging.
Yeah, I think so. And I want to remind folks, you saw what Trump did yesterday at the news conference, how he shut down the media. And don't think that he's not going to shut down the media. And don't think that the media will not be fearful of Trump.
And he's not even in office yet.
And he's not even in office yet. Now, about it. We must stay alive. And we tell you that every time we come, but I know you know that. And please don't wait for the other person to do it. Please be that caller that never called before. Please be that caller that is calling to renew their membership. We need you more so than ever right now. So I'm asking you to invest in all of us, you included. Invest in us all. Let's call 713-526-5738. I don't think you said the number, Kay. Let's get you to say it.
Let's make sure we heard. 713-526-5738.
Absolutely, folks. We need you. We need us. You know, I always loved that phrase that the president used to say, and he says, you are who you've been waiting for.
Yes.
And, you know, one of the things that I preach, one of the things that I blog a lot about is self-worth. And I have always said that one of the problems with America right now is that we are severely lacking in self-worth. We have allowed a plutocracy to tell us that we are not worthy. We are only worthy of what some are willing to offer us. And we go ahead.
Absolutely. The fact that someone told you that you're not great.
Exactly.
How can somebody come in and say, be great again? No, I'm great right now. I'm becoming greater.
Absolutely. So the thing about it, though, is we have to deprogram ourselves. But the deprogramming doesn't happen in a vacuum, right?
No.
We have to empower ourselves. We have to also invest in those who have the ability to help the empowerment of others. And, you know, that is what we preach. That's what Shannon preaches. That's what Kay preaches. That's what Teresa preaches. That's why we are here. We are trying to tell people. We're trying to say, hey, you are worthy. Don't listen to what they're saying. But you know what? We can't do it alone. And we need your help. We need your calls. We need your green, to put it bluntly.
We
need your money.
You.
And, you know, one of the reasons I love working at KPFT, and one of the reasons I love working at KPFT, to put it bluntly, for free, is because I can come with the ask and say, I am doing this out of love of country, love of city, love of my people, and my people is all of you guys.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I can tell you that anybody who you can talk to, anyone who is in our domain, that is what it's all about. We are all about, we want to support everybody. And you know, Shannon made a kind of a funny about, well, I hang with Tea Party folks and Republicans and so forth. You bet your life I do. Mm-hmm. You know what? I love them just as much. I just look at them at sometimes and say, like, I want to talk to them. I want to say, hey.
Is she crazy cousin?
Yes.
And you gonna still love your crazy cousin?
Yeah, and they think I'm their crazy cousin too. And you know what? But what we need is you. And in order to promote our values, in order to help people bring up their, understand their worth. I mean, when you hear me talk about the plutocracy, when you hear me talk about, well, trickle-down economics doesn't work, and I give you the reasons why in an understandable manner, the reasons why. You see, a lot of people believe that they were led to believe that liberals are either quacks or that somehow they just want something for nothing. Not at all.
No, we cute now. We coming Beyonce style.
Yes, so, I mean, what we're trying to do, folks, what we are doing is we're trying to build our worth, everyone's worth. We're trying to tell folks that you matter. We're trying to tell you to get into the body politic because you matter. So, folks, please give us a call. 713-526-5738. Again, I'm asking 713-526-5738. Yes, we do need you. Yes, we do depend on you. Yes, without you, we are not existing.
And we talking to you. We talking to that person right now in that car that just picked up their kids and they behind that bus. They can't go no faster than what they can go right now. Just pull on over, take a breath. Call 713-526-5738 and donate.
Folks, we've got 4 minutes. I know you can do it. I know you can bring me over the top. Teresa, do we have anything else?
Hey, yes, yes. We do have two more pledges, mm-hmm. But we still need more. And we have to thank Aaron.
Thank you so kindly, Aaron.
Aaron gave $50. Thank you very much, Aaron.
Thank you very much, Aaron.
And we have Michael. Now, I see no stories. When you call in, tell us how you discovered KPFT.
Absolutely.
Let us know. Give us a little bit of feedback on the show. Hey, that Alberto is so perceptive. Yes. And so positive. And such a problem solver. And so open. I tell you, your work with the coffee party inspired me.
Well, Teresa, let me tell you a quick story. I know we don't have a lot of time. But folks, please call 713-526-5738. I want to say that you inspire me. You inspire me for the amount of work that you do, not only at KPFT, but out there in the body politic. So, I mean, it is great for us to give each other kudos because...
Well, I just texted some humanist friends.
Great.
Maybe they're going to call. And I just texted some Bernie supporters.
Absolutely.
And I just... Hillary supporters. I just texted them, so they might be calling.
Absolutely. That's what we need. We need you all, folks, to participate. We've got 3 minutes to go. So, folks, give us a call. 713-526-5738. We're almost out of time, but we do need you. 713-526-5738. Do you have anything that you want to say real quickly, my dear Shannon?
Well, you know, this place is so unique, and there's nothing like it anywhere around. Honestly, if you can't donate today, if you can't, then we can get you involved as a volunteer in another way. It's all about people powered. Either people's energy, people's passion, or if you just value this resource and want to make sure you support it financially, whatever you can give, that is what this place is about.
Absolutely.
Bringing people together.
Absolutely. So, folks, we still have a couple minutes, 713-526-5738. I think we are getting close to that number so that we can earn that $200 that Teresa told us about. So give us a call, 713-B. I want to hear that phone ring before I get off the air. We brought in Kay West from the Houston Area Progressives, a woman that is doing a whole lot of work. She came back from simply being a lady that decided, I am going to make a difference.
Absolutely. I decided that I wanted a better world for my kids.
And there you go. We all want a better world for all of our kids.
Be the change you want to see.
I want a better world for Shannon.
Please.
Shannon is a millennial. Shannon works hard.
It feels like it's been a hopeless world, but we got to have had a little hope of our own.
Right. My daughter is a millennial. I want a better world for my daughter. 713-526-5738.
713-526-5738. Folks, we got 1 minute. 713-526-5738. Please give us a call, and we'll call your name on air if you want us to. And look, Kay West.
Absolutely.
Look, it was my pleasure meeting you, and it was my pleasure having you on the show, and I hope to have you back again. This is Egberto Willis. This is Politics Done Right. Thank you so kindly for being here. Remember to go to Politics Done Right on Facebook and like the page. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye. Done right.
Thank you very much for listening to Politics Done Right. I am your host, Egberto Willis. You can personally reach me by sending an email to egberto@politicsdoneright.com. Remember, Egberto is spelled E-G-B-E-R-T-O. Change starts with you. 90.1 KPFT gives you information not tainted by corporate interest. Please visit kpft.org and contribute. Let's ensure continued access to real information and news remain available to all. Again, thank you very much for listening to Politics Done Right.